What's up, YouTube? It's Josh Hewitt, Top Form Fitness. Once again, time to do it with Hewitt. And today I have with me JT Van from Precision Striking. Thanks
How's it
for
going,
joining,
guys?
Buddy.
Nice to meet you.
You don't
right
be
on.
Hanging there, bro. I hooked up with Jason recently to do a couple of videos with regards to boxing. And a lot of my clients have been asking about boxing or pad work for fitness.
Yeah.
And this is something, I mean, I've been sticking with the same old boring jab cross, like same old boring combinations.
Yeah.
I love doing this for interval training, but I wanted to mix it up and sort of learn a little bit more technique so they can learn something along the way. And I thought maybe I'd have you in to sort of show me some of the ropes when it comes to pad work, but related to fitness.
Yes, okay. So yeah, in this video, what I want to do is break down some ways that you can make the boxing a little bit more advanced and a little bit more technical for your clients. So you may already be working with clients for boxing in the fitness realm, or you may just be a boxing fanatic and working with your friends, holding pads and doing some training. And if you haven't officially trained in boxing, your knowledge might be limited to a certain point. So in this video, we're going to go over some more of the technical details and a few more complex combinations and scenarios. Again, you don't have to use all of this because sometimes you have clients who really aren't interested in more of the technical stuff. So if you have a client who just wants to throw those punches and work, then you can keep it at that. But if you find as you go along, you want to make things more interesting, and you have clients who want to do more advanced technical stuff, at least you have that knowledge base so you can add it to what you're doing in their workout.
Yeah, that's perfect. And this would be great for some of the trainers who are watching if they want to incorporate this with their clients. And also some clients who are watching this, if you want to share this with your trainers, let them deal with the technical stuff, right?
Yeah.
You get a great workout out of it.
So we're going to get on the gloves and the focus pads, and we'll get started and build things up step by step.
Awesome. Let's do it.
All right. So the first thing we're going to go over is stance. And the ideal stance is important so that you can get those punches off so that you can maintain balance and move after you throw those punches. Now, again, with your clients, you might not want to get too technical on stance, but if they ask you questions about why they're having a hard time with certain punches, you may notice that the problem is in how they're standing. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get Josh to straddle this line right here.
Okay, one leg front, one leg behind.
Yes. Now, the main thing is that you want to be split between a line. So, for example, if Josh takes his right foot and puts it on this side of the line, let's say he's too narrow that way. So if he's too narrow here and he tries to throw this right hand, he can't get his hip through because he's too narrow as well.
I'm also off balance.
And he's also off balance that way. And if he's too wide, let's say you step out this way, he's going to be too square, he's too open up the center, and he won't be able to get range on his shots when he's throwing. So the ideal distance is to straddle a line. And so he's going to straddle the line, lead foot 45 degrees, rear foot 45 degrees, right in the middle there. As well, another test you can do is that he might be a little bit too close. When you bring your knee down, once he brings his knee down, you should be able to have about a fist width between the knees. So if you bring your knee down, yeah, so that's a little bit close. Maybe you want to put that foot, this back foot a little bit back. Yeah, that's it. And then bend your knees and body upright, facing forward. Okay, now the next thing that clients often do is they like to put their elbows by their side like this. So what you do is you get them to reach their hands out as far as they can reach, and then they're going to get the back of their elbows and touch it to their ribs right in the front. So he brings it back to there, and then when he brings his hands up and drops his chin, now he's right in the perfect position. Should be able to see his chin right through the gloves, just right in the center line, or it should just be right in the middle, eyes just looking right over the gloves. So that's sort of your ideal stance to get things started, and you're gonna notice that as clients punch, their stance will shift, and then you can sort of tell them, all right, you gotta get that foot back out, or you gotta be a little bit longer, but at least they have somewhere to start from so that they know what the benchmark position is. Okay, Josh is in his stance, hands up, elbows in. Now, the first thing that I might do is I wanna get used to Josh moving with me. So instead of just the straight punching, I also want him to be able to adjust distance and not always feel like they're reaching or not be too close. So what I'm going to do is Josh is going to hold out his left hand, a straight jab, like so, right here. Now, from that distance, he's going to bring his hand back to his face. Okay. Now, this is sort of like a general ideal distance. He can contact the pad from here. Now, what I'm going to do is just to get used to moving with him, I'm going to move forward and he's going to be sort of like an opposing magnet. When I move forward, he's going to move back. And then when I move back, he's going to come back in forward. What I want him to do is sort of keep this distance in relation to me, so he always knows where the right position is to punch from. And there are ways we can adjust this, but we're gonna start with this for now. Okay, so here I am. I'm as the pad holder, I'm just gonna start moving. I move forward, and then he moves back in a little shuffle. I move back, and he moves forward. Now, I can do this a couple ways. I can walk, which is sort of like a shift walk, like so, or I can move back with my shift walk. If I wanna liven it up, I can do sort of a gallop. So I'm gonna move forward in a little gallop, yeah? And then I move back in a little gallop. Now, he holds out the jab, there, and that's the distance we're looking at. I go back, good, forward, that's right, back, forward. And this is great for just getting your client used to moving with you so that you're not always staying in the same place. Also so that your client or the person you're working with doesn't crowd you, right? That the punches are so close or up in your face, or so that they're not too far away. Get them used to understanding distance.
And one thing with the stepping, I notice a lot of clients want to cross over or they end up...
Yeah, that's right.
So you want to make sure they sort of keep, move back into their position every step, right?
That's right, that's right. Footwork is a whole other topic together, but what's very important is that in boxing, you take small steps. So there are cases in real boxing where you can take big steps, but for the most part, it's small little shuffle steps that go quickly. So, and staying within that stance position in general. So as you see, if you look at Josh's feet, as he moves back, he's taking small little steps to keep in general position forward, and then he can still reach. We'll go on to the first punch, which is the jab, and we'll work it two ways, with and without the step. Now, generally, one of the common mistakes you see when people throw a punch is that they're gonna throw this punch, and then this hand is gonna drop. So what I wanna do is make sure that, give them sort of a reminder that every time they feel a punch, that they should feel this fist on their chin right here. So I don't want them to let their hand drop. And that could be one of the first things that you work on. It's just, as one punch contacts, the other hand is right on the chin in an ideal position. So here I am, we're gonna do 10 of those. We're just gonna work with the jab, no stepping or moving for now.
Okay.
As Josh throws the jab, his elbow will be down. Once I get to that 90 degree position, he's gonna turn it over, and then he's gonna extend the shoulder. His chin will be tucked, looking forward as he can. And this is the ideal reach right here. So his chin is almost behind his shoulder. Might be a little too technical for a client, but at least you know you want that chin down and straight forward and the shoulder extended straight out. Okay, when you want to bring the hand back, just relax it straight back. Okay, so let's work 10 of those with no step. Ready? One, good. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, good. Now, if I want to do a little test for his other hand, I can get him to hit this pad here, and at the same time he hits that pad, I might do a little tap just to remind him, nothing too scary, but just a little tap to remind him of what's going on. So here we'll do 10 of them, ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, good. So next, we're gonna add a little bit of an extra element moving with the jab. In boxing, in order to get to your opponent, you do have to step to them and close the gap. And the easiest way to do that for now is just get them to move the front foot. So now, I'm gonna stand a little bit further back from Josh. As he throws that jab, I want him to step just about 3 to 4 inches forward to close that gap. So from here, as he holds out his jab, just hold out that jab, I don't want him to be able to contact me, because that means I know he's already within range. I want him to actually, yeah, have to close the gap with that front foot. So this is another way that you can get your client getting used to more realistic boxing, also burning a few more calories, getting a better workout, because now they're getting their feet involved as well as their hands. So ready, he reaches out the jab, but he can't reach right there, he's gonna have to step to it, brings the jab back, and ready, let's go for 10 with the step. One, back, two, three, four, five, small step, six, good, seven, eight, nine, 10. So that's one way you can work it, moving with the jab, getting a little bit of footwork going. Now if I want him to commit more, He's gonna actually take that front foot, and that back foot is gonna just come in a little bit. Boom, the full body, yes. And then when he goes back, that back foot will go to go back. So that's when you wanna really commit to the jab a little bit more. So from here, he's gonna move the front foot and the back foot together to really come in and commit to that jab. Ready, let's go for 10. One, nice. Two, good. Three, four, yeah. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. All right, solid. So those are different ways that you can work footwork and also work the jab from a basic position, just throwing the jab, or also stepping, moving forward. So now we're gonna go on to a few other punches, break down the single punches, right hand and the hook and the uppercut, and then we're gonna work on putting them together in different combinations. So now we're gonna go over the right hand. So Josh is in his stance, in his position, elbows in, hands up. The key with the right hand is to keep the body upright as it turns through and to pivot that back foot so power comes through, as well as keeping the other hand on the chin when he throws it. So yeah, exactly like that. So from here, in general pad work, you're gonna work opposite to opposite. In case you don't know already, typically my left hand, he hits with his left hand. My right, he hits with his right. So it's opposite directions, but same side, right to right, left to left. So to work the right hand, he's in his stance, hands up. And from here, when he throws that punch, I'm just gonna meet it, and I wanna check his overall position. So he throws the right hand, holds the position, boom, I hold it, meet it. Here, he's good, looking forward. His balance is upright, foot is pivoted, that's nice. Maybe I get him to come through a little bit more there, and I could even get a client to exaggerate this pivot just a little bit, but that's the main thing, that the hips come through. This right side of the hip comes ahead of the left side. And then when he goes back, all he's gonna do is relax the elbow down and bring it straight back. Okay, so let's work a few of those. We're gonna work 10 of those. All I want is for him to work on that pivot, and as he's working that, not to let the foot start to fade out and lose that position. So you can pivot, and if you have to lift it to adjust, that's fine. So ready, let's go for 10. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now, one thing I'm catching a little bit is a little bit of a lean.
Reaching. Yeah.
Reaching, I want him to get the hips down and through, more so than a little bit of a tilt. That's right, so just a small little thing. Okay. In case you want to adjust your client that way, again, if you have a client that's just more into the fitness and workout stuff, just keep them busy, don't worry about it too much all in one session. Ready, let's go for five more. Okay. One, yeah, he's sitting on his punch, screwing that back foot into the ground. Ready, two, good. Three, good. Four, five, nice. Now, the other thing I'm looking for is when he's throwing that right hand, he's keep the left hand on the chin. So we'll do about five of those, and I'm gonna look for that. Ready, one. And I'm reminding him that when he feels that contact with the punch, he feels this on his chin. Ready, two, good. Three, four, five. All right, nice. Now, if I want, I can also work footwork and have him work this punch as well. So I'm gonna move forward, he's gonna move back. We move, I hold up the pad, boom. I move back. Here I might use this just to set the reach, make sure he doesn't get too close. Set it up, boom. I move forward, boom. I move back, boom. And there we go, setting up the right hand. So while we're at it, let's move on to the lead hook or the left hook. If you're working with a southpaw, someone who's right-handed, they'll have their right leg forward like so. You're gonna have to adjust for that. The techniques are pretty much all the same, just different sides. So we're gonna work with the lead hook. Now, lead hook is best thrown off of the right hand or off of this setup. You can throw it by itself, but for now, for simplicity's sake, we're gonna work it off the right hand. So when he throws the right hand, he's gonna pivot just like before, he holds it out. Now, the general thing that I want is, let's say, keep you in your pivot position. General thing that I want for that hook is he's gonna bring that right foot down and turn and pivot through. That's the main thing. Set that back foot down and turn through. So right here, he brings the right hand back, sets that foot down, and then turns and then comes through. That's for the lower body position. So I get him back. We'll work on the upper body in a second. He throws the right hand, holds, sets that back foot down, comes through with a front pivot. Other key thing is I want him looking forward. And what you want your client to do is hit here and only go a little bit through the target. Because let's say in real boxing, he hits my chin, boom. After here, full contact has been made. Only about 4 to 6 inches through. So he hits and then comes through about 4 to 6 inches. Then just relax that hand back and comes back to the stance. Okay, let's work on the lower body two more times and then we'll talk about upper body. Right hand, then left hook. Yes, looking forward, looking forward. Right hand, left hook. Yes, there we go, looking forward. Right hand, left hook. Good. Now, for the actual upper body, main thing, you don't have to make it too complicated. Main thing is that the elbow supports the fist. But the elbow is in line with the fist so that this...
parallel to the floor.
Parallel to the floor, exactly. It's all in one straight line. Now, you can have the fist this way or this way. It's not as big of a deal as is often made out to be which way the fist is. And there are different scenarios, but for the client's purposes, it's not really a big deal. They may prefer this way, they may prefer with the palm down. Sometimes with the palm down, if they don't hit it right, they'll hit with their thumb. So let's say Josh throws a hook. If he doesn't fully get that fist in and hit flush, sometimes they catch with the thumb. So this way sometimes makes it easier to hit with the knuckles. But again, you have to gauge your client and what you're comfortable with. So let's go, he's gonna throw the right hand, the left hook, and freeze on the left hook position. Ready, right hand, left hook, boom, freeze. So I got him there. See, elbow supporting the fist, wrist straight, he's looking forward, front foot pivoted, and back. Now let's say he wants to throw right hand and left hook quickly. You don't always have to pivot. If your shoulders come through and your hips come through, you can get a little bit of power. Pivoting is for when you have a power shot. Let's say the client's gonna go boom, but don't be so particular if the client doesn't pivot. You can always just get them to go one, two, and just a short little turn with the shoulders. So in this case, Josh is gonna go right hand, left hook, not necessarily pivoting, just throwing them off, boom, boom. Okay, let's go for that a couple times. Good, and now get that hook right out there. Yeah, there we go. Good, more turn on the right foot. Yeah, more turn on the right foot sets up the lead hook better. Let's go back a bit. Right hand, left hook. Yes, good, right hand, left hook. Good, bring that elbow out far. Yeah, right hand, left, yeah, that's what I'm looking for.
Okay, yep.
That's right, that's okay. Good, there we go, right hand, left hook. Yes, good, right hand, left hook. Yes, good. All right, time. So let's put a little combination together. One, two, three, just holding in a spot. It's sort of your basic combination. Jab, cross, lead hook, and cover. Ready, right in your spot. Good, I'm gonna set the range here. Boom, two, boom, three. And I wanna make sure he's pivoting on the right and then maybe possibly pivoting on the lead hook. Ready, go. One, two, three, good. Now, after he's done, another little thing that I like to do is he holds the hands up. Just tap my client lightly to make sure their elbows are in. Your client might think that you're trying to attack them and they're gonna put their elbows up to block, but you want to emphasize that it's mainly to get them to keep their elbows in so that they're not flaring like this. And it's sort of like a nice way to reset after they throw any combo. So he's gonna go one, two, three, and I'm gonna do tap, tap, just to remind him to keep his elbows in. Ready, go. Tap, tap. Go on. Good, and you see that? He dropped the right hand on the left hook, so you gotta make sure they remind him to feel that contact and contact each time. But it's not always gonna happen, just once in a while you gotta do a reminder. So ready, go. One, two, three, yes, that was good. Go, one, two, three, good. Tap, go, one, two, three. That's it. All right, nice. Okay, good work, Josh. You're coming along.
Feel dangerous.
you're dangerous, man. You're gonna be ground and pound,
that's
you know?
It.
So next we're gonna go on to the uppercut, and then after we're gonna work on some more advanced combinations. Okay, so next we're gonna go on to the uppercut. So you can add that as one of the punches in the combinations and in your arsenal. Now there's a few common mistakes that people often make with the uppercut, especially beginners. So we're gonna go over them right here. Yeah, that's right. So I'll get you into your stance and your position. Now, anything off that rear side, like the right hand, overhand right, right uppercut, it's gonna be the same thing. The foot pivots through, the hip pivots through. With uppercut, a lot of clients or a lot of beginners are gonna try to rise up with the uppercut, and you gotta try to discourage them from that. The uppercut is more of a twist, and it's more of a lever where this backside goes back and this side comes up. The other problem is when someone rises up on the uppercut, then they have no balance for the next punch. So the combination pretty much ends there. If you keep them low and they turn, now they can easily get in that next punch setup. So from here, let's just break down some of the details. The first thing with an uppercut is there is a setup or a preload. So Josh is gonna bring his hand to his chest height. For the right hand, we're gonna go off the power side, so yeah, to his chest height. And then he's gonna pivot the foot and drive it through while bringing the elbow and shoulder out and looking forward. So you don't want this to be too tight in there like this. You gotta get that shoulder out and the elbow out to come right through. Yes, exactly. And the other thing that he's gonna do is make sure that he sits back with his backside, sit right down, let the arm do the work. Try not to let the body do the traveling for you. And the final thing that we're gonna work on the detail of is make sure that when he throws that, he goes right up the middle. Yes, that's right. Okay, so let's go over a few of those really slow. Pivot, sit low on the shot, pre-set up, and come through. Ready? One. Yeah, and then back. And two. Good. And three. Yes, good. And four. Good. Five. Good. And then six, hold it. Good. So see here, I want this nice and flush, almost like I could balance the pad right there. That's how nice I want that uppercut to go boom and hit straight through. Uppercut to the body would be different. He would come through me like a spear. But for now, we got this uppercut to the head. He's gonna come up right elbow in the middle. Same with the body, bent knee, sitting down on that shot, body twisted, not lifting up. Because from here, if he wanted to throw the lead hook, he could just pivot, bam. Nice, yeah, and the right hand, nice balance all the way through. So let's work on a few of those. It's okay to have a little bit of a preliminary setup with that hand coming down to the chest, driving up, and making sure that elbow and everything comes away from the body. You don't want to be too jammed in, like so. Okay, so ready? Let's go for 10 of them. One, two. Now, you might notice a client go too low. You don't want them to go too low. About the chest or stomach height is okay. So yeah, right there. Ready? Yeah, three. Good, four. Nice pivot. Four, five. Now, put a hook right after it. Six. Yeah, good. And he's got his hand back. Nice, that's just what I'm looking for. Seven. Yes. Eight. Nine, 10, good, all right. So now we're gonna work a little exercise that you can work with your client, and that is just having them react to single punches. And this is sort of like a warm up just to get the punches and the distance flowing in addition to some of the footwork stuff. So here Josh is in his stance. All I'm gonna do is hold up a pad and he's gonna knock it down like we're playing whack-a-mole. So here, yeah, exactly. So here I hold up the left hand, he throws the jab, brings it back. I hold up the right hand, brings it back. I hold up the left hand, lead hook. I hold up the right, uppercut, like so. And then I can just do whatever I want. I can work whatever I want. Right hand, jab, uppercut, hook. Oh, he got that one, right hand. That's it, jab. Good, jab, good, right hand, good, uppercut, hook, all right, nice. So that's a great game you can, or a great drill you can do with your client just to get them working the different punches and moving around. Another way you can do that is while moving, but we're gonna add a little bit of movement to the forward and backward drill working in a circle. So what we had before was I move forward, Josh moves back, keeping the distance. He moves towards me, I move forward a little bit quicker, and then I move back, Now, another way you can work this is working around the clock, working in a circle, the way boxers move. I'm gonna circle to my left, he's gonna circle to his left, so we go this way. And all the while, what I want him to do is keep that lead foot pointing towards me, so that he's always ready and working. I go back this way, to the right. Now let's say I wanna set up the drill that I was setting up before, where we throw random shots. I hold up the pad. Right hand. Nice, we move. Then I hold up this pad, throws the jab. Then I move, and then here. Yeah, that's right. Then I move, and then maybe I move back, and then here. Now you're getting your client used to working with you and moving with you, throwing the basic punches and moving at the same time. Now they're getting an extra good workout using the feet, using the hands, and having a little bit of fun, and we haven't even really gotten to any advanced combinations yet. So let's say Josh and I just do this for 30 seconds. I'm moving, throws a jab. I'm moving, yeah, stepping into those shots. I'm moving, throws it, good. Back, hook, yeah, nice. Uppercut, I'm moving, back this way. Jab, that's right. Hook, yes, perfect. Okay, so these are some great drills you can do just to get things flowing. We covered the uppercut, getting your client moving, working with the single shots, moving forward and backward, and then stepping it up with a little more intensity. Okay, let's put together a few combinations. Now, when working with a client, they're not necessarily right or wrong combinations. In boxing, there are some scenarios that will make more sense and that are more common. And so we're gonna do sort of a standard combination, but we're gonna add a twist. Most of the time when you're working with a client, the punches are going left, right, left, right, left, right. So in this one, we're gonna make a little bit longer of a combination and we're gonna double up on the left side. So Josh is gonna go double jab, right hand, or sort of straight right hand. Then he's gonna go double left hook, right hand. In fact, what I'm gonna do is actually gonna get him to throw an uppercut in there. So I'm gonna go double jab, uppercut, double left hook, right hand, boom. And then I'm gonna cover to make sure that he's doing all right. First we're gonna do it stationary, then we're gonna do it moving. Okay, so I'm in front of Josh, get that nice range going on, take a little bit of a step back, and from here, nice and easy, nice and slow, double jab, uppercut, double hook, right hand, and yeah, just to cover and make sure that he's in a good position. So we'll go again, easy pace, double, uppercut, double, yeah, really smooth, that's it. Again, double then uppercut, double, right hand, good. And as you get more flow going, your client can pick up the speed, but this is a nice way to get the hands going, working the doubles off that lead side. So again, double with the uppercut, double, and going. And as the pad holder, again, you're just meeting the person into the punch. Tap, tap, good. Then again, double, up, oh, that's right.
Good, here we go.
Yeah, up, double, boom, man, moving back a little bit. So now I'm gonna get him to move forward. Basically, what I want him to do is move forward on those jabs. Boom, boom, to close the gap. And then he can start working the power shots once he closes the gap. And as he comes forward, I'm gonna move back as well to simulate the opponent moving back and him closing the distance. So here we go, moving forward, double jab, uppercut, double hook, boom, good. So just like in boxing, he closed the distance on the opponent and then opened up with power shots, and you can work that simulation with your client. Yeah, nice, really good. Again, moving forward. Yes, really good. Turn that right hand over at the end. Moving forward. Yeah, good. And one more time. Ready to go. Boom, boom. Okay, so next combination, very similar. Gonna work the basic punches, but we're gonna try to put them together with more speed. So we're gonna be working the left-right pattern back and forth. So nice and easy. Josh is gonna throw the jab, then the uppercut, then the left hook, so sweet jab. Uppercut, left hook, right hand, left hook, cover. So this is a nice smooth combo, just working left and right back and forth. Once you build up the flow, then you want to get your client going into the speed, and this is where you're really going to see them work and that kind of pressure. So if you can get the rhythm from this, bop, 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 to bop, 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 bop. You want to get that, you want to get that speed built up. Okay, so let's, I know, I'm just getting to relax. So let's start easy, jab, uppercut, hook, right hand, hook. And one thing I like about what Josh is doing is he's not changing his levels or rocking. All he's gonna do is just sink and let the body twist and the arms do the work. Stay nice and low and balanced and not shift all over the place. So it's important that your client does focus and maintain their balance throughout the combination.
Do like Josh does.
Yeah, do exactly like Josh. Jab, up, hook, right hand, left hook. Good. And then, boom. Ready again. Jab, up, hook, right, left hook, yes. Boom, and stay nice and close there, right in there, right in the range.
Yep.
Ready, go. Jab, up, hook, right, left, good. Now, one little thing, a small little detail that you might want to work on is when, let's go through this combo, freeze on the left hook. Jab, uppercut, left hook, freeze. Now, what I want is I don't want this right hand way coming from way back there, because then it sometimes comes wide. What I want to do is keep the elbow nice and close. Right in there. It's not always easy to do, but if you can get your client to focus on a closer elbow, then that right hand, instead of coming from way back there, is coming nice and straight, right short. So let's do that a couple times slowly. Jab, uppercut, hook, yes, and then a tight, yes, that's it, and then left hook, bong. And always looking forward. Yeah, they're always looking forward. Ready, let's go again. Jab, up, hook, right hand, hook. Yeah. Yeah, good stuff. A few more. Jab, up, hook, right, hook. Good. And again. Jab, up, hook, right, hook. Good. Again. Jab, up, hook, right, hook. Bom, bom. Jab, up, hook, right, hook. All right, nice work, Josh. We're gonna move on to ducking and how you can integrate that with your combos and then finish up with a little punch out conditioning drill. All right, so next we're gonna add ducking to the combinations. And ducking is a great way to add extra work for your clients so they can get a little bit of an extra workout with that ducking, working the legs, working the body movement, and also to keep it closer to realistic boxing, to add in an aspect of defense.
A little bit of defense.
Yeah, a little bit of defense.
Like a bunch of little squats in there too, it's hard work.
We're gonna work them, we're gonna work Josh right here. So, but first thing is in general, if he's gonna throw the right hand, he's gonna duck under to the right, which basically means that he's gonna be going clockwise. Now, when he ducks, let's say I get you to face the camera straight, looking straight on. I don't want him to duck and make too wide of a swivelly motion. All you're gonna do is make a tight U and come the tightest U you can. So here we are, yes, that's right. Now, if you go the other way, we're gonna go this way, turn, and then under a very, almost like a horseshoe shape, a very tight U. So just to break down those details. And when he throws the right, yeah, he's gonna duck under that way. And when you throw the left, we're gonna duck under that way. When he hits the pad, it's gonna be easier. So I'll get you set up again. So he throws the right hand, he goes under and back. That's right. And what I wanna do is, when he goes, I wanna get the pad and just go behind the head at the back of the neck. So that's like a nice easy way to do it. So here, boom, I go under, that's to keep it real, and bam, comes up with that second right hand. Nice and snug. And the only other important thing is that your client has to generally keep their eyes forward and up. Make sure that when they duck that they don't look at the ground, eyes forward. So from here, right, duck, right, smooth, slow pace. Right, duck, right, good. Right, duck, right. Right, duck, right. Now, all of the things the same with the boxing, keeping that foot pivot through and then coming under, that's gonna make things easier. Now we're gonna work the left hand or the left hook. So let's make it easy. Right, left, doing the duck, coming up with another hook, smooth, slow speed. So in your position, right hand first, left hook, under, boom, exactly. Now the key is on that first hook to come through. So that you can come nice and under. You don't want to come short, and then what you end up finding yourself is that you're cutting back. Come fully through on that first hook. So you're right, left, yeah. There, get the client to come fully through so that their motion is continuous and smooth. Yeah, that's the one I'm looking for.
Good.
Ready. Right, left. Right down under. Right, left. Yes, good. And then one more. Good. Now, what you can do also to make it a little bit more fun for your client or work more of the footwork is after they throw and duck, they're not gonna come back with another punch. They're gonna throw and duck and step out and take off and work around the clock. So what Josh is gonna do, he's gonna throw the right hand and duck, and then after that, he's gonna go under and step and then come around to the other side of the clock. So that way we're working a little bit of footwork and punching together. There we go, moving, 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 moving. That's right. Now we can do that off of any combo that finishes with the right hand. So let's say one, two, and then he goes. One, two, and then he goes. Then we could go one, two, and then he goes. One, two, and then he goes. Or we could do one, two, hook, two, and then he goes. One, two, hook, two, and then he goes. So now we're gonna add one final part is moving after the left hook. So he's gonna throw the right hand left hook, step under, and then move, and then we're gonna do that full circle thing. Yeah, and then you're gonna take off, step under and take off. So right hand left hook, I go into him, he takes off. That way you're kind of working a little dance, a little movement with your client. Right, left, yeah, that's right, that's right. One more time, right, left, boom, good. Now, last final piece I'll give you is just to throw the, like we did off the right hand, duck, right hand. You do the same thing with the left. Left, duck, left. Two, three, yes. Two, three, two, good. One more time. Two, three, two, three, two. All right, nice, good power coming out there. So you can see with ducking, you can work it a number of different ways. You could put two or three ducks within a combination. When they throw the right hand, they go under. Clockwise, can throw another right hand. Left hook, go under, throw another left hand. You could put any combination you want before the duck or after. You could put two or three ducks into one combination and work it like a chain.
As long as it always has that rotational flow to it.
Yeah.
And like when I get it right, when you're not fighting the duck, you're moving with it.
That's right.
You get more power in the flowing punch you can find.
That's right, you continue with your flow. Now that's not an absolute rule. In boxing, you can throw a shot and go the opposite way and throw a shot. There is a technique for that, but for the most part, you're gonna have a client go with the flow. Throw and flow, that's gonna be generally the easier way, although of course, for your own self, that's not the only way. Mm-hmm. Then the other option is, have that client duck and get them moving, working that footwork. That's why those footwork drills that we did earlier are so important, so your client gets used to reading you and adjusting to your distance. Okay, so a couple workout drills or conditioning drills you could do with your client. You might be doing these already. Simply the shoe shine and punch outs. And you could work sort of any time setup that you like. I prefer to do a tabata, which would be like 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. And you can switch between. So you can do 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off for one of the techniques for three or four in a row. And then let's say the last four sets you can do a different technique. You can also do 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off, or you could just work in 10 second bursts. Whatever you like also depends on the fitness level of your client. So for the shoe shine, I'm simply gonna get my client to square up, to face me square. And what I want him to do is throw continuous uppercuts, but I want them to roll. The reason why I want them to roll is because I want that elbow and that shoulder to come forward. I'm trying to get them to bring that forward as opposed to just little short jam punches. I don't want that. I want to try to get them to release, to bring that arm forward. Not always gonna be possible depending on the speed right off the bat, but that's the idea. So I'm gonna meet Josh with the pads. Let's go slowly. Right, left, opposite to opposite. Let's keep it slow here. He's releasing like so. Now time, very nice. I'm gonna get you to go a little bit lower in your stance. Yeah, a little bit wider, like so, yes. And so we would work this, let's say, for 20 seconds, take a little break, and go again. And we wanna build up the speed, but also keep that flow, not short, jabby shots. The rolling flow is very important to release the shoulder at the back. So ready, start with the right, and go, one. And then here we count it, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time. Good, take a little break. And then you could do again like four sets or eight sets, however much you want to push it. Let's go for a second short little set. Ready and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 time. Okay, so the shoe shine is one great way to really work your client, work in that uppercut position. You don't have to be too technical. As long as those arms are rolling, try to encourage that. The next one is just a standard punch out. And again, with this technique is a little bit important. You want those punches to go beside each other. You don't want them rolling them. This is the opposite. You don't want them rolling. Hands beside each other, and you want them to go straight in and out, like you're throwing them down through a pipe. You don't want this and the left hand. A lot of people tend to drop the left hand. So I'm gonna be on Josh's case to keep those hands up. Left, right, left, right. We'll go for 10 seconds or so, 20 seconds, and you can work this as a Tabata set. Starting with the left, ready, continuous, slow, 1, 2. And then he's gonna build up that speed, keeping that left hand up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 time. All right, nice work, nice work.
Got ahead of myself.
So that's right, speed and technique. Again, you have to decide how strict you want to be on each.
You guess your cardio and your core is tight too the whole time.
Yeah, you gotta brace yourself.
Workout,
you gotta brace yourself.
All right,
ready? We'll go for the second set, second and final set. Start out slowly and build it up. And yeah, nice, nice. Left hand up, good. 5, 4, 3, 2, tie. All right, nice work, buddy. Good work, Josh.
All right, everyone, thanks for watching. If you got any questions about these drills or any combinations, you can let me know or post a question on your channel as well.
Yeah.
Make sure you check out Jason's channel, JT Van, on YouTube, and I'll put the link down below. I'll put it on the screen here as well, a direct link to it. And you can also find you on precisionstriking.com.
Yeah, that's my website.
Check out his website. A lot of great drills on there and a lot of good tutorials that you can check out there as well. If you're really into boxing, this is the guy to go check out. Post some social media links down there below as well. All right, man. Thanks again for joining me today.
Yeah, man. Thanks.
Awesome tutorial.
Yeah.
We got a great workout in today. Thank you all for watching. And until next time, stay strong.